Yeah, sure.
Awesome.
Excellent.
Great.
Excellent.
Give me a shout when you're ready. Sure. 3, 2, 1, go. All right, so this is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone for the PC. And so if there are people here that saw this game on the list, we're looking at it and thought, oh my god, this game was my childhood. You're probably wrong. There's about 5 different iterations of this game. This is the PC version that I'm going to be running today. There's also, there was a version for the PS1, a Game Boy Advance version, a Game Boy Color version, and then in 2003, 2 years after the initial release, they released versions for the 6th-gen consoles, PS2, GameCube, and Xbox. I have no idea why they came so late. I don't know what was going on. I don't know too much about that. But the first 3 minutes and 16 seconds, we're going to be watching this very long long cutscene. So feel free to go and get yourself some popcorn and some drinks ready for this. We're not going to be doing very many inputs, except right at the end of this slideshow, I need to hold backwards so that I can save 2 seconds by speeding up the camera in a cutscene, because cutscenes are interesting. We're going to see a lot of times where I'm going to walk backwards into cutscenes as well to make the camera will move around quicker in the cutscenes, and if there's no dialogue, I should be able to gain control a little earlier than I normally would be able to. I picked this game up back in like 2013. Back then, we had the likes of Gymnast running this game. Shout outs to Gymnast86 and my boy Keymaker, who had a time of 1:33:37 back then. And we all saw that as an unbeatable time. Now, 3 years later, we are looking at trying to get 1:21:51 as a goal time right now. Shout outs to FractNL for the 1:21:51 meme, who managed to PB twice in Harry Potter 3 with that exact same time, ever so slowly being faster and beating the previous world record, which was 1:21:51, which is pretty based.
The infinite meme.
The infinite meme.
The loop.
Oh, dang.
Oh.
That's not a good sound.
All right. So after that initial cutscene, there's some more cutscene going on, or I guess dialogue.
Cutscene on cutscene action.
This game likes this a lot.
I can't hear any game sound. I've just decided. I'm not sure if you're getting any.
I'm not.
No.
It's fine. I don't need sound for a while in this game, but there will be a point where it might be useful if we can get this going. I guess you could fill us in on there.
I wonder if, I don't know if the stream has audio right now, but
yeah. While we're sorting this out, I guess we've got time for a few quick donations.
Yes, we have a few donations waiting here. We have a $5 donation from Tekio saying, "Great job to all for this event, and big up to Restream FR." A $5 donation from PaV1 saying, "It's always nice to start watching the stream and see Pac sitting at the commentator's table. Hi, Pac." Thank you so much. And we have a $5 donation from Ixar saying, "Flipendo, flipendo. Also, I love your voice, Pac, Kappa Pride." Thank you so much. I'm flattered.
It is a gorgeous voice, Pac.
Yeah, big laugh for Pac.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I guess we're going to be introduced to how it is that we platform around Hogwarts. Fred and George are here to hold our hand as we get taught how to do anything, pretty much.
We're taught how to jump, how to climb, how to pick up beans. Yeah. Very important life
you
skills.
You obviously need to learn
very
that.
very friendly people, for sure.
For sure.
Yeah. Holding Harry's hand like that. Helping the first year students. It's always a good deed.
It's fantastic.
So yeah, I guess maybe we could do like a roll call or something.
Oh, of course.
So I think we did that.
I'm Respirte. On my left we've on my left we've got THMCS and Menno888. Behind us, we've got
a
bunch of peeps.
Dang. All right, so you're supposed to be able to have jump all the way to the that little gap you saw to the other part. Like, it's not a big deal. It's just like a jump that the jump he just did. He could have done that like in the cutscene or whatever.
I wasn't supposed to let peeps hit me.
Yeah, it's fine.
Wasn't really on it.
So there's a cutscene skip coming up here. Res was going to jump around a trigger, just like that. And now he's going to get his bean count to 25 before he'll start the next cutscene. So, yeah. He's going to attempt to do a strat called the jammy here. And
damn.
All right. So pretty much what happens there is... If you get a let's grab in the cutscene, which is what he attempted to do, he can actually gain movement.
Yeah, and he could the game forces you out.
There are actions that can interrupt cutscenes, such as grabbing a ledge, taking damage, or being moved from the position that you're in. So if a character runs past you during a cutscene, when you're slightly out of place, is the way you should be.
Well, you should probably touch
small
down
deal.
On this game's amazing physics like that. Mm. You can actually let's grab stuff that doesn't exist as long as you start the let's grab from like where it starts, I guess.
Yeah.
So what you saw Rest there literally just jumped out of nothing because the game was in a state where I thought he let's grab the bookcase from the front.
And so the game sort of slides you along the ledge until it finds resistance and stops you. Also, really hard skip coming up. I hope I can get this.
Oh yeah, Hermes skip. Let's go, boys. No space.
Saves about 15 seconds if I can get this. Nice.
Literally just walking around him. Yeah. Big applause for that one, guys. Yeah. I mean, I will say, like, it's incredibly actually easy to mess that up sometimes. It's hilarious, but it's really easy.
Oh, we have got sound now. Sure. Okay.
All right.
Dang.
Not bad.
It's a good weather out here, huh?
Yeah.
It's not bad. So there's sound coming from there, not through here yet.
I guess it's an audio problem. The audio was like really low.
Audio like this. Oh, bass. My boy Fluff.
Oh, what a
Wait, what?
Okay, we're fine.
Oh, hang on. That looks slightly de-stretched out, should be fine.
The colors look a bit different too.
Mm.
I guess the window isn't selected.
Maybe? That should be a little further down. I'll leave it.
Oh well, whatever. It's all good, you know?
While we're sorting this out, I think we've got time for more donations. Am I right?
You are correct. We have a $1 donation from Vesaverst that says, oh no, Blackcloud bleeped, Blackcloud and Blackcloud bleeped, Blackcloud. I got, why are you laughing? Was that like rude?
It was German.
Yeah, okay. Well,
nice meme.
I'm terrible. We also have $5 from Red Tusk that says, hey Resp, I'd have given you a dank meme, but I couldn't come up with any. Good luck with the run.
Thank you. Hello? Yeah, sure. I still haven't got audio through my headset, though.
Yeah, I've got a bit.
Did? On the mixer, it's all the way up. On the speaker, yeah. Yeah, in-game, it's higher.
I mean, you could boost it, I guess.
I could.
Also, the system speaker isn't turned all the way up. Like, it's only on, like, 70. Keep going up.
Okay. Nope. Maybe?
Yes, I think I might have some audio.
Oh.
It's like very quiet.
We can give him the wrong headset.
Oh, glorious.
Excellent. And we'll switch.
The good old switcheroo.
There you go. There we go.
Stretch. All right.
Can you hear it now?
But there's no audio in the menu.
I think so. I'm not sure where I'm hearing it from, but I can hear it. Yeah.
Yeah. I can hear it a tiny bit.
Yeah.
I can hear the menu sounds quite quiet.
Oh, there they are.
All right.
Okay. I think we're almost ready to go again.
Yeah. The resurrection of the speedrun.
Dang. Feel free to count me in whenever. Okay.
All right.
Cool. Ow.
Right. So, this game, like, in order to learn the minigame, the space, the audio is really
sound.
Fancy.
Yeah.
You have to draw the symbols. Each
Wait,
one
what?
Has
I love it.
Right.
No. I didn't know Quirrell was an android. I'm not gonna lie.
I mean, the game it did flash.
It did.
It turned black for 1 second. I don't know if you messed with a cable or something. But the audio is interesting.
I don't mind continuing like this.
This is like kind of funny, actually.
I can still work off audio cues with this. Okay, that's the music now.
Christ.
Oh, God.
I'm so sorry.
I mean, yeah.
Oh, God.
Okay, I can.
Alright, we'll reset, boys. Let's go. Let's go.
Oh, God.
Oh,
what's going on?
Right. Let's try again.
It never ends.
It desyncs some, but it shouldn't happen.
That shouldn't happen like that.
The pause does nothing to the games at all.
You could do. I mean, I've got save point at the start of Appendo, which should be fine. But no, the sound's still. I guess we can use the menu to work out.
Was the sound still fucked?
Yeah.
Damn. Oh.
Oh, that's better. That's much better. What did you do? It's working.
Oh, try and load a game for audio.
It might have just been too high on the speakers, maybe.
Oh,
gorgeous.
What the? Okay.
Amazing.
Well, I mean, okay, let's go, guys.
Yay.
Come on. Woo. We have to run now.
Okay. Right. Ready whenever.
Alright. Alright, we're back in there.
Okay.
Alright, so much like the other Harry Potter games, at least in the trilogy, the first three ones, each spell you'd learn had a little challenge to it. This is no different. This is Flipendo, and it's pretty much used throughout the game to interact with objects or activate switches. like we can knock over cauldrons like Grohl is telling us now, but we'll also use it later on. There's something called dry storage, which we'll abuse by... basically all spells are the same, they just have different like visuals. So if I throw like a Flipendo on something that's Wingardium, it will still actually... it's just the work same.
So that right there was pot skip. When you tip over a pot, the hitbox of the pot is extended on its side, and you can use that to get to higher up points, and you're able to jump over to the room with the switch there, which you'd normally have to go and hit another switch and then go all the way around the bridge and hit a switch again to get there. So we're introduced to save books here. Nick,
hello, Harry Potter.
Tells us the glorious
nearly headless Nick, the
use
house ghost.
Of saving and being able to continue now, progress, which luckily we were able to do once we enter Flipendo with this game.
Your game
yeah.
Will automatically be saved.
Also, we've got plenty of time for donations now, so if you want to get them in,
if you faint,
I'll call them out.
You can also
yes, sure,
load
we've got
a
one
saved
right now
game
from
the main menu.
$5 donation from Flap Times 100. Hey, Resp, you're doing poor man's right. Better be. Hashtag flap for more.
Dang. You wish, Flap. You wish.
Good old Flap. No, but I guess just a general footnote is whenever we like, we're not really talking much, donations can always really be. This is a very chill run.
It's very chill.
There are a few sections where there will be a lot of explaining. Like, we'll see something called a hyper jump here in a little bit. But whenever we're not talking, pretty much. Nations, that's a hyper jump right there. You basically use the walls or whatever is around you to get a sort of extended jump or like a boost.
And safety save here.
It skips ledge grabbing and it's just really, really slow to ledge grab, and we'll do the same here, skip a little bit.
You see it two more times here, hopefully.
Yeah, it's pretty much just... Oh!
Oh, nice!
It's pretty interesting.
That wasn't quite it.
But, you know. So, another thing that you might not remember from this game, or that you can't really see just by watching, is the game controls like a tank.
They're atrocious.
It does not control well.
That's
however,
like my maximum turning speed.
Yeah, it's pretty bad, but it's okay. And
bearable. When you can work with it.
Exactly. And you'll see it specifically here, but also later on. But there's actually some really tight movement coming up. And it doesn't look too tight, but... some of these strafe jumps you have to do are pretty stupid, considering the game's movement mechanics. He'll like try to catch a cycle here. Whenever he flips Flipendo over here, that block in front of him is going to move. He's going to see if he can cut a corner here, land on it faster, like that. And that's it looks pretty easy, and it's not the most difficult thing in the world, but the strafing doesn't help. Let's put it like that.
It's a relatively straightforward thing. So we're introduced to gnomes here. Gnomes will steal your beans when they bump into you, and most of the time they're just used as enemies that you need to clear out to trigger an event like opening a door. Also, this is one of the only times where I'll be using the mouse to control myself, because they're a pain in the ass to hit with arrow keys. Most runners use mouse to run this game. I'm one of the exceptions, along with, I believe, Rashler also just uses arrow keys and control alt for jumping and casting spells. It's just a preference thing. Technically, it should be faster to use mouse and WASD because you get an increase in turning speed. But I'm just so used to mouse, arrow keys, and control out now, and I can control things a lot easier using that.
But there was little time to dwell on this, since Harry and his friends were expected back in their flying lesson some cut with Madame Hooch.
Story
time. It's always nice.
Story time. But I can't remember who did the narration for this game.
Madame Hooch. Your first lesson will fly through these magic rings.
Stephen Fry did it in 2 and 3. They did a solid job of it. Oh, never mind.
Harry's just having fun on the broom. Yeah.
And Nearly Headless Nick is also done by John Cleese, right?
Oh yes, of course he is.
Ready, Potter?
I'm not sure if he is in the game as well. So this is going to be a broomstick segment, sort of Superman 64-esque. We've just got to fly through the rings. They'll progressively get smaller, and later on they'll start moving around, but their hitboxes are kind of in the same place, so they're sort of exactly the same as the earlier ones. This will be... probably a good time to call out donations if you have any.
We have $5 from Annie Ross 99 saying, "Hey Rest, I've got around to giving my second donation of the marathon. Glad to see a Harry Potter game making it into the marathon with an amazing runner at that. Also, shout out to representatives of Dumbledore's army at ESA this year.
Dumbledore's army representing?
And call me Hagrid."
No.
Oh.
Alright, that's
no.
A no. Sorry, mate.
No.
Maybe next year.
Let's try.
Yeah, Dumbledore's army's a pretty chill group of individuals that run this game, sort of adopted the name from Order of the Phoenix's little gang that Harry and his friends set up.
Yeah, it's pretty much just a gang of Harry Potter speedrunners. And
it's full of memes.
Yeah, it's a cesspool. It's bad. Don't ever go there. But it's pretty much just the people that like to watch Harry Potter speedruns and do them themselves. You know, around the community.
There's a good number of people that hang around, chill out. It's a nice place to be.
Yeah, we'll have fun.
It's good times. So I'm glad we finally got this running smoothly.
Yeah.
Some good shit.
So now Hermione is very excited. She's going to learn us a new spell. Because apparently she is allowed to do that, I guess, and give us like house points magically. So, I mean, that's pretty good. We're going to utilize this spell a lot throughout the game as well. Or Respirte, I'm not actually playing, actually.
That might have been ridiculously good.
Yeah,
okay, that's fine.
Dude, like 84. Not bad.
So one thing I didn't get to mention last time around because we had all those audio issues, you only need to pass the first round to be able to continue on. So when it gets to the second round, I intentionally fail just to be able to progress.
Yeah.
Also, all of the characters have different lines, different bits of dialogue for dealing out the house points and saying whether you passed or failed. There's some faster, some slower, so there's like times where you get ridiculously bad lines and it can slow you down by about 3 seconds per dialogue line.
It's up to RNG really, and the game to decide what kind of dialogue it will give us. Obviously nothing much that the rest can do about it.
This is one of the shorter spell challenges as well. It's just cycling around three or four rooms and opening two doors, three doors even.
It's a very useful spell.
Alright, let's hope this works.
Right, Hermione should be blocked by a student here, and she is.
Awesome.
This is really good. This means we can now do the multitask, and pretty much what it is that because we didn't talk to Hermione...
It's about to get a bit crazy.
Because we didn't talk to Hermione, the game never put us in the place where we're supposed to be to learn this minigame, to learn this spell even. And the game is kind of confused, so right now Resp can actually move Harry around while he's learning Wingardium Leviosa. So what he's going to do is he's going to actually walk to the next part of the spell challenge. Like, you'll see the camera going a bit bonkers here. And like audio overlapping and stuff like that, and like learning minigames while casting spells. Like, it's pretty interesting. It's pretty interesting. But it works, and it's fast.
Luck, Mr. Potter. Doesn't know where to go. So that saves about 40 seconds because you're essentially doing both of the sections at the same time, which cuts doing both of the sections. Another pot jump here. You can make this without the pot, but it's recommended.
I'm going to do the clip.
Of course I'm going to do the clip. It might not work, but... Okay, so that's the wrong face. That's the wrong face.
Yeah, this block is kind of finicky.
I don't normally go for this. Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, nice. The Ultra Wingardium.
There we go.
Alright, so that Resp mentioned some faces of the kind of like box before. Two of the sides will clip the box backwards and two will clip them forwards. And if you have the box facing forwards, it'll go through the fence, I guess.
This was like very recently sort of figured out.
Yeah. just assumed it was very inconsistent before, yeah. But there is actually consistency to it.
I'm not sure if it's consistent which face it is when the map loads, or if it changes periodically, because I feel like I've had times where I've done it the exact same way before and it's been one face over another. We're still not sure about it.
All right. So coming up is something a little bit extra interesting, I guess. Rest was actually going to beat the Wingardium challenge without actually walking all the way over there. And like we were in on earlier, spells in this game have some pretty fancy properties, and hopefully he can get it. But if he...
I'll just put it here now.
Yeah. If he,
there's two ways of doing this.
Yeah. He tried to do the fast one first, but it's also more...
Yeah, tricky. You can only do this in the British version, I believe.
So if you're like, what just happened there? Basically, the spell kind of like... It's almost like an extended hitbox of Harry himself, if that makes any sense. Like, the game thinks that Harry walked into the trigger when it was just a spell also first boss battle.
Alright, cool.
He's having a lot of fun. And being stuck here. Yeah, if you go into that corner, Peeves will just be very easy to just completely manipulate.
There's a lot of places where you can do it, but I find that corner, he generally keeps to himself and sticks around.
Experiments. Yeah. Once again, the Weasley twins are just like up to no good.
So yeah, going back to the Wingardium thing, if you put a block on top of you and then try and cast up to it, this game doesn't recognize casting spells upwards, so it essentially will try to do that, and then we'll end up just casting it forwards instead. So the shot will go out in the direction that you're facing. And there's going to be a similar place where we're going to do that with a Lumos statue, to far cast at a Lumos statue later on. I'm going to attempt this, it's not going to happen, but we'll...
It's a super jump here.
No, it's inconsistent as to whether you'll even get the ability to get the clip, and then it's a frame-perfect super jump, so...
Yeah,
we've got time for donations here as well, if
we'll
you want to.
We'll touch in on super jumps later, for sure.
Cool,
that's more evident.
Sure, we've got one here. $10 from Chuck Chopper. I was so bad at this game when I was a kid, I failed to beat, spoilers, Voldemort Quirrell at the end and threw the CD out of the window. I look forward to seeing you beat that bloody, spoilers, Quirrell.
Dang.
Ooh.
Oh, perfect.
Coming up here is Malphite Skill.
Oh, not perfect. I'll damage you, not perfect, actually. Oh, no. Okay, that one.
Alright. Pretty much you're supposed to beat Malphite in a little wizard cracker duel here. The rest of us really like that, so he's not doing a great job right now. There we go.
Oh, I'll do it.
Pretty much what you can do here is you can do a neutral jump to get behind the line and trigger sort of like Harry's exiting here without actually having to
over
beat Malfoy.
Here.
You can get a little bit unlucky though, and that was the case in this case. And now we talk to Hagrid. Hello,
the door has a pretty big trigger. You just have to get close enough to it to be able to activate it and go through.
Yeah, pretty much you just walk up to it and then let go of the direction after you jump and hope for the best. Your friend Hermione. But yeah, it is not. It's pretty straightforward, really.
Faces are gorgeous in this game as well.
Yeah.
Only Harry has a 3D model of a face. The rest of them are just pasted.
Yeah, it kind of just looks like a cylinder with a piece of paper wrapped around it.
It's pretty gorge.
Yeah.
The herbology lesson is just past Professor Sprout's garden.
Also, flowing hair.
I'll wait here for Neville.
Of 2001.
I think we've got lost again. Go on, Harry. You better get to the lesson.
Yeah, we better get to the lesson, Harry.
We can get on that. Bit of zigzag.
Kind of zigzag. Alright.
Bit of zigzag lots.
So yeah, you can skip all these things, I guess. You can jump up here, and yeah, you're supposed to hit all those flippendos to open the gates, but after you've, like, I don't know why, I guess the gate just lowers its hitbox slightly, but you can, like, actually jump on it after hitting the first two flippendos. And you can,
it's strange, you do have to open the gate before you can first get on it.
Yeah,
but then
that's the thing.
From
it's
there,
strange.
It's relatively simple. These are venomous tentaculars. They would normally bite you, however, in this particular section, if you just jump past them, their hitboxes won't catch you and you won't take any damage from them. So we're just going to rush off to our fourth class, which is Incendio. If there's time for donations now, you're more than welcome to read them out.
Okay, $2 from Lazar181. His comment is quite interesting.
Dang.
Fly to poles, Harry, when I see Flipendo. Fly through the poles, Harry. My hand automatically goes to the blodger. Fly through the poles, Harry. I strike the blodger and I feel I have Leviosa. Fly through the poles, Harry. With the super jump, all becoming Dumbledore. Chest barrier skip or not. Also, shout out to your boy, Mikael. Fly through the poles, Harry. You'd better watch out for my bludgers. Please stop that.
Please stop that.
Please stop that.
Please stop that, Lazar. He's an interesting guy. Used to hold the record for this game.
Known legend in the HP community. Also, another 69. Oh,
twice in a row.
Not bad.
Harry is really frisky today.
You have great potential.
Yeah.
5 points for Gryffindor. Try to go a little bit quicker this time.
So, I wouldn't say recently, but I guess it's amongst some of the newer strats, kind of.
But unfortunately, it's wrong.
Semi-recently, we're talking maybe like 8 months ago, so it's not really that recent, but the game doesn't really see too many major changes.
Now it's time for the Incendio Challenge.
It was figured out that we can actually skip a cutscene at the end of this. There was like a big wave, sort of like new discoveries. Most of them have been obsoleted now, but one of them haven't, and it's a... You'll see it at the end of the challenge, but you can actually skip a cutscene by simply walking properly because of where triggers are.
Interesting placement of triggers that allow for...
Yeah,
nice things that happen.
Pretty much, you'll exit through a door, and the door has a like kind of a trigger zone, and on the other side of that trigger zone, the cutscene trigger zone is. But you can just kind of like hug around it. It's a little bit weird.
Just sort of edge your way forwards until the door shuts.
Yeah. Oh, hello. Venomous Tentacular.
And then just walk around the back after it's closed. Hello.
Wow.
You don't normally need to worry about health too much in this game, other than fire seeds, maybe, and then the boss fights at the end, I guess. Okay, so I'm going to leave these doxies alive, and there's a reason for that. When you pass a doxy and trigger their movement cycles, they enter a state. You enter a state called Scowl, and essentially the doxies will be trying to attack me constantly, no matter where I am in the level, and this allows me to utilize a trick called dry storage, so I can store casts and cast them from afar wherever I am, and then I took damage from the gnomes to be able to move during that cutscene to get to this door.
Yeah, you have to make sure that the cutscenes don't overlap.
Otherwise, oh, that's true. Yeah. If you walk there too early, as the door is opening, you've got to wait for the cutscene to end. Otherwise, you are stuck. There's going to be, hopefully, a small cutscene skip here. Each of these Flipendo switches that I'm going to be hitting trigger opening a different part of the door, but if you hit them simultaneously, it will just play the cutscene for one of them, and then I can walk during the second. Stacks them up. I'm also probably going to be trying to get the rest of the frogs this level. It's just good to go into the next sort of sections with full health.
Yeah, full health is always good.
That was another attempted hyper jump to skip a ledge grab.
Yeah, we're just climbing this tower very slowly. And let's hit the Slipendo.
And then just falling down. It's actually a pretty smooth fall.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It obviously unlocks the stall as you saw, and we can continue on. Oh, our merry way.
Oops.
Oh.
On our merry way.
Yeah.
That might have screwed these cycles up a bit. That's fine. You can sort of just walk through this.
It shouldn't really be a problem.
Shoutouts to triggers.
Yeah, you can just literally cast Flipendo 4 times on that. You're supposed to cast Flipendo on each of the 4. But
great
can,
programming.
Yeah, you can literally just like spam one of them and it's pretty good. And this is what we were talking about before with the cutscene skip. Yeah, just like that.
Natural instinct to go and split.
Alright, so hyper jumps are interesting. And we're going to try, Respa's going to attempt another one here. And it's a little bit tricky.
I'm only going to do this twice. It's kind of a finicky one.
There we go. Nice. That's good. What that does is that it skips Hagrid's little cutscene here. Where Hagrid talks about, like, come to tea or whatever.
Let's go and see what he wants.
But we can just skip that by jumping on a bush.
So Longbottom has gone snivelling to
Malfoy
you,
being, like, a badass. Thinking he's, you know, the coolest guy around. Yeah. How about he's a real spagger. And he has, like, his little red pack gang here.
Think you can catch me? Come on then, Potter.
His cronies have fantastic laughs on the Dutch version, I've
yeah.
been told.
Oh, yeah.
Just gonna help my broom again.
Harry just way. Like... Harry has no respect at all. He's ready to completely destroy this kid. So yeah, we're just slowly bunking into Malfoy. I get to remember all, you know, normal Hogwarts stuff every day. Everyday stuff.
You'll pay for this.
Standard issue.
Take this
yeah.
Thing.
I remember this from the book.
It's my favorite part.
Yeah.
You've got my remember all back. Thanks, Harry. I'll be able to find my toad now.
So yeah. Just returning to remember all to Neville. He's a good
hey,
lad.
Trevor.
So.
Come back.
A nice guy.
Yeah.
I mean, he broke the rules about not being able to use your broomstick.
I remember now.
As a first year.
I left Trevor near the herbology class.
Yeah.
There are plants there that eat toads.
I'm sure the head of Gryffindor will give him a scolding.
I'm Professor McGonagall, deputy headmistress
yeah, sure.
of Hogwarts and head of Gryffindor House. Although I do not approve of your chasing Malfoy about, I'll admit you have remarkable talent on a broomstick.
She can only shake her head or nod.
Yeah, some very advanced animations here in this game.
Sort of reset the cycle there.
Yeah. Very well, like, rigged 3D level.
Well done.
Yeah. Shoutouts to No Wonder for being amazing at making video games.
In all fairness, No Wonder did pretty good jobs on the HP games when they were developing them for PC.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I would say these games, like, they kind of still hold up, and you know, really good for their time. Also, this is a super jump, and that looks kind of like that. This is didn't even get the. I mean, this is still okay. I mean,
it's fine.
It could be
it
faster.
Was pretty quick.
Okay. Yeah. So okay, I don't know if you've noticed, but sometimes when Harry walks over small things, he does like a little like he jolts a little bit, like he does a little jump as you walk over. And what that is like it's one frame where Harry has like an absolute obscene amount of momentum. And if you can manage to jump on the same frame as you get this momentum, you get like an incredible jump out of it. And we call those super jumps. And what he just did here was what we call Fizz, Forest Edge Skip. Going straight to Hagrid.
I made that look ridiculously easy, but it's not. It's a one-frame trick at like 120 FPS.
Welcome
it's
yeah,
kind of insane.
Small,
you're supposed to do a bunch of platforming here, and like you have to spin that log in the middle of the clearing, and you know it's just a big hassle. You know, why not just like fly through the air like a true wizard? Like screw that other stuff. Who cares?
It's what you would have wanted.
I mean, I would have done that on any given day.
Oh, for sure. I can't leave it here alone, but I need some fire seeds to give it that last burst. Gorgeous close up of Hagrid's face coming up.
Oh yeah, Hagrid is a real stud.
And his hands.
Yeah.
Out in the garden. Fantastic.
Fantastic.
I need you to collect as many fire seeds as you can find. Careful though, they're spitting fire and the seeds are hot. Let them cool down before you pick them up. Off you go then.
Off you go, Harry. So, Hagrid is perfectly content with sending an 11-year-old out into the forest filled with dangerous like slugs and duxies to fetch fire seeds for an illegal dragon that he won at a poker game. So I mean, this is very PG right now, and
for sure.
I mean, Hagrid is a top lad, so of course we're gonna you know catch him or throw him a bone on this one, but.
We'll do as he says, we might as well.
He's a bit shifty. He's alright, but he's a bit shifty.
That doxy that I killed at the start, if you don't kill that doxy for whatever reason, sometimes when you complete the level, you can get to the end and it won't give you the trigger to get to the end of the level, and you just have to go all the way around again. We've no idea why that is, so for safety, we always kill it in general.
I mean, you can only assume it has to do with the state you get in when they chase you.
But I left that doxy again for more storage shenanigans.
Yeah, you'll see a lot of storage shenanigans in this particular level. He tried there. But
it saves like 2 seconds if you can hit that early. But
you'll see it later as well, some stalagmites.
And we'll see a significant use of it during the introduction to the Fire Seeds cutscene.
We might also see our very first wall walk, unless you're not going for it.
I'm going to go for it. Yeah.
All right, good stuff.
Shout out to Max G.
Finding a lot of wall walks, not only in this game, but also the second one.
The Wall Walk King.
Yeah. Max G just kind of like came out of nowhere.
He really did.
Found a lot of good strats and got record for a while too.
Yeah.
Of course, now it's Monkey Dudes.
Shout out to the Monkey Dude for having a 123.30 I believe.
It's pretty good.
Came out of, well, not came out of nowhere. He's been around for a while, but he suddenly beat the record by about a minute.
He kind of just got that time, like, very surprisingly out of nowhere. But obviously, he's been around the Harry Potter community for a long time. Like, he's
been there for a good few years.
Yeah, known for having done both 1, 2, and 3. He does all of the games, really.
He's pretty solid at all of them as well.
Well, I mean, he doesn't do the shit ones, but the
actual ones. Oh, no, the bad ones. No,
so, yeah.
He sticks to what he knows. So that there, you saw me far cast at the Fire Seed plants, and that just meant that they were able to cool off during the cutscene, so I didn't have to wait for them after casting at them to pick them up.
Yeah, that's still all to do with the dry storage. You wouldn't be able to hit the Flipendo from that far away, but the dry storage allowed him to throw it prematurely.
And obviously because we're thieves. We just stole the word joy storage from Wind Waker.
Yeah, I mean, we do that all the time. There's Fist 2 in HP 2. Or Hiss even, sorry.
Oh yeah, there is the hyper-extended super slide for wizard cards. It's pretty nice.
It's pretty good. I mean, there should be time. Oh, wait, actually, maybe we should wait with the donations.
I think we've got time for donations now, yeah. War Walk's not coming up for another 40 seconds.
Well, it's not going to take too long. We have 2 donations from Anonymous, both with $15. Thank both of you very much for your generous donation.
Shout out to Anonymous.
Thanks for the host, Anonymous.
Yeah, good up. Yeah, just, you know.
So earlier when I was walking past the venomous tentaculars on the wall.
Oh, there we go.
You were able to see me sort of like walk close to them, like close to their bitey head bits, and you won't take damage if you're standing close to the part that's attached to the wall. Also, that was the wall walk.
Yeah, the wall walk. He just skipped a pretty significant chunk of platforming there. You'll also see it looked a bit strange with where that boulder was going. What happened was that Harry's supposed to come from the other side of the boulder and then hit Flipendo to crash the wall. However, we were obviously on the other side, and the boulder doesn't actually do any damage. So luckily, we just kind of like, using the power of biology, just osmosed through the rock and it smashed the wall still. And now we can kill Hagrid in his devious deeds of
popping all fire seeds.
Yeah.
There's a lot of cutscenes here, so if you guys want to do plugs, you're more than welcome to.
You've done it, Harry. It's hatching.
Yeah. Hagrid's very excited with this illegal dragon.
Fantastic.
Norbert. Norwegian ridgeback,
you know. You know.
Up you come, the beauty.
Thanks, Harry. So this is where we're given the flute, which only has one use for about 30 seconds. Later on in the game with the should be an exciting game. The trials. Slytherin's a tough team.
Yeah, you can definitely go for a donation or two, if there are any.
Yeah, go ahead, guys.
Okay, thank you very much. We have a $10 donation from Shadowplay65, who says, Resp, how goes the memes? Also, shout outs to Saving Kids.
Yeah, can't save them all, man.
Dang.
Welcome to Quidditch, by the way. This is like the only like good Quidditch minigame in any of the PC games.
In 2, they made it worse. Like, unbelievable.
It's even worse in 3. Like, 3 is just a cutscene. Like, They went from having like an actual decent minigame for Quidditch in Harry Potter 1 here. In 2, it's literally like an auto scroller.
And
you just have to yeah, well, 6 is just like completely you have to like beat up a seeker in HP 2, but otherwise it's just an auto scroller, like you can't really speed it up much in that regard. And then 3 is literally just a cutscene where Harry gets kinda messed up by some Dementors. So shout outs to Harry Potter 1 for keeping it real, I guess.
We get to see some of the fastest Quidditch matches in history as well.
Yeah.
On this version. Get time for a bit more broom humping.
I mean, there's a reason he's like the youngest seeker of the century or whatever. He's like a known legend.
This should take about 14 seconds. Yeah.
He's dining straight for the snitch. Catching it like a pro. There we go.
In there.
Yeah, come on. Applause for that one.
Thanks, Lee Jordan. Okay, so the camera and the dialogue kind of get a bit janky sometimes in this section. So you can get fascinating.
Let's plets, quick.
A lot of the time. The
game's very confused sometimes. It gets easily confused in this. Kind of like overlapping and... The younger seeker in the history of
Hogwarts. We do have time for more donations now, if you want to read some out. Congratulations again for winning. We're just heading over to Lumos. You are fantastic. Something is troubling me, Harry.
Ron and I heard strange noises outside the Forbidden Corridor. So, come up to the third floor and have $1 anonymous donation. Early a $15 anonymous, plus this one from Ozzy and family. Resp is awesome.
So we're going off to learn the last spell now, which is Lumos, the illuminating spell. The uses that Lumos has in this game is purely to make platforms exist that don't normally exist. So you cast Lumos and then there's some bright light platforms that appear. You just do some more platforming and ledge grabbing and...
Please stop that.
Please stop that.
Nice. It's, the Lumos. Lumos, obviously, in the books and the movies and whatever, is something that's supposed to just illuminate and, like, give you a light in the dark. In this game, it shows, like, magically hidden platforms, and it's very reminiscent to, like, the Verdimilia spell from, like, the PS1 games, if you played those, as opposed to this one. But, yeah, that's something that you guys will be seeing, and it will be utilized in platforming from now on out.
We're also going to abuse the walking backwards during a cutscene strat to make most of the Lumos gargoyles speed up an awful lot. This was something that was only found a few weeks ago, so there's still a bit of exploration as to what cutscenes are faster to walk backwards in and which ones aren't. Let's take a look before
Filch comes back. Yeah, this game is still relatively resourceful. I'm sure there's more stuff we haven't found yet.
I think I said back in when we had like a 130 as a time that 120 was probably going to be the pinnacle. And we're nearly there, so somebody can then prove me wrong and get a 118.
Slowly but surely getting there. For our defense against our carts lesson. Well, I mean, I guess technically we're going pretty fast if we get low times, but...
Indeed.
No, it's a process.
Today, we learn to illuminate dark magic with the Lumos spell.
So it's either been 80s or 69. What do you reckon? Then
hold down the mouse. Wait, I'm gonna go for the triple 69.
Triple 69? Yeah, I'm gonna go for the 80s.
Alright.
And I am drawing it, so you know.
Yeah, I know. But it's fine. Look, see, you're not even gonna get 80 for that.
Yeah.
Told you. That's enough.
That was a shaky effort, Mr. Potter. So yeah, that was one of the longer dialogue lines. That I got there.
Did he just say that was a shaky effort?
That was a shaky effort.
He beat it, though.
I did. The thresholds are, like, they have different comments for 50 to 79, 80 to 99, and then there's a special one for 100. Oh, and 0 to 49 you also get. Negative feedback.
Krill is such a negative Nancy. But maybe I would, too, if I was wearing That's very bad like that. I wonder what's on the other side of it. No spoilers allowed.
I miss Android Quirrell.
Yeah. Android Quirrell. Yeah, his voice was pretty good.
Mm.
It's definitely like a step in the wrong direction here.
We haven't had any... there's occasions where if you enter a music loading zone, you can get... the music will either be slowed down or very rarely the music will be sped up and the pitch is also shifted. I guess it's just a little problem the game sometimes has loading in the audio. It'll either speed up or slow it down.
Bit of glitched audio never hurt anyone.
Never. A bit of sped up audio is always fascinating to hear as well. So this cutscene is going to move pretty snappily. Comparative to what it would normally do. Because of reversing backwards after hitting that. This one over here, it's not really worth it to walk backwards because you've got to move close enough to the... You've got to move closer to that position where Harry moves into before it starts spawning in the Lumos.
And suddenly platforms.
Suddenly platforms.
And for some reason you also get a cutscene for most of the gargoyles, except two, I believe.
Oh.
No reason why.
Yeah, there's two in dungeons where they decided not to bother with the cutscene mechanic. And then in HP2 they practically drop the whole cutscenes because it's a little bit slow. Also, you may notice that my star count is 7 and I've only picked up about 2 because of the way I've been exiting the Wingardium and Incendio challenge. I don't actually end the level, I don't end up talking to the teachers, and so they don't subtract the stars from me, and so I get to stock them up. And even now I won't be giving any of these stars to Professor Quirrell. I'll save them all for Snape, who's just going to take house points off me anyway. Because there's one more lesson end trigger that we're going to abuse.
It's kind of strange how the cutscene actually speeds up just because Harry moves backwards.
Yeah.
Still don't understand it.
I mean, I'm trying really hard, but no wonder.
But no wonder.
Yeah. For those who don't know, that was the No Wonder is the company that created Harry Potter games for, well, the first 3 ones for PC. Also, obviously, the Legendary Shrek 2.
The Legendary Shrek 2.
And other games.
Okay, I think... Oh, I just missed... No, I didn't. Okay. Alright. So that was another use of the dry storage, where if you get close enough to an object from a different angle, you can then cast... The spell won't go into the place where it thinks it wants to go, and we'll just shoot it forwards so I can hit that gargoyle from over there. If we've got time for donations, feel free to read them out. Sorry,
yeah,
we have
actually
time.
Actually, we have a $100 anonymous donation without a comment.
Damn.
So that is like...
it's 1,000.
1,000. Thanks to the government, the US government.
Shoutouts to the US government for the tenfold on all donations this year.
So what Resp just did here was he actually positioned himself quite precisely here. As he sort of like hits the Lumos, he won't get bit by the Doxy. That gives him movement in the cutscene, and he can just kind of like save a few seconds over waiting, I guess.
You're able to get hit earlier, I just slightly misjudged it. Oh, that's...
Nice, let's grab.
That's going to put me off the cycle, so I might as well grab health now at this point. I think I'm lost. Oh, I missed him. Never mind. So there's a student just randomly walking around this class. Yeah. This is the only class where you see another student about.
Being helplessly lost forever in the Lumos challenge.
I think he's lost.
Poor Ravenclaw student. I think it's a Ravenclaw.
I actually can't remember which.
I'm pretty sure it's a Ravenclaw, but I might be wrong.
Chat, which house do you think he was in?
I don't know.
So yeah, off the cycle. You can normally make it onto that.
It's pretty interesting how I have audio in my headset from a game being played next to me. This is Harry Potter 2, I want, you know.
Dang.
I'm hearing many Futurama noises right now. And yeah, this is another usage of dry storage.
Nice.
Once again, leaving the level with the Flipendo.
Next is our potions lesson, and it looks like we're already late.
Ron looks really interesting when he talks.
So potions is essentially just going to be a collectathon of fetching ingredients for Professor Snape to make a potion that we're not even going to get to make because he's just going to kick us out the moment we get back. Also, there's a risk of a strange softlock right at the start of the level, so I'm going to be grabbing a safety save as I get into it. And hopefully we won't have to worry about that. If it happens twice, I'm going to assume it's just going to keep happening. I'm going to cheat. I'm sorry. Just a warning.
Respa's a known cheater. He hacks pretty much all the time in any game. So.
Dang.
But yeah, called out live at ESA.
Yeah, I used the turbo controller and crashed it.
Yeah, same. So, don't worry. No. In all seriousness, though, the game... It seems to have like an evil eye for Resp in particular, because like he's the only one that gets it from what I can see. Cause, but then again,
I've seen a couple of people that also get it as well, but I seem to get it relatively frequently.
Like, obviously, it's not something that never happens to anyone else. Like, but it seems that Resp gets it fairly often, so
hopefully we won't have to worry about it at all.
Yeah,
but it's right here.
Yeah, it's a stupid soft bug that literally makes zero sense, and it won't happen. But
it won't happen. But we've talked about it, so it will happen.
Yeah, we jinxed it, pretty much. But yeah, for whatever reason, sometimes... I guess I won't even mention it. Let's just see if it happens.
Flipendo! 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 Flipendo!
Moment of truth.
Flipendo!
Alright, not bad.
Flipendo!
Okay, never mind. Okay, so sometimes that block can just get stuck in between the two blocks that you push down in order to make the bridge for it to cross, for it to get across. No idea why, but generally when it happens, it will continue to happen, and so there'd be no way of being able to progress, realistically.
I mean, I guess it's most likely a case of just a bad hitbox.
Potentially, yeah.
Like one of the blocks that you push, extending its hitbox like upwards somehow. I don't know why it would, but that's the only thing I can.
Maybe it just doesn't align and slot in properly.
No, a little bit.
No, pretty good. I think so.
Oops. You'll see some more kind of like tight movement here. Once again, I mean, it's not like. Super hard, but it is strafing in a game with no strafe, so
the only time you can strafe is in midair.
Yeah. I like to just completely and utterly bash this game for its movement because it's actually horrible. But I won't do that.
I mean, you're more than welcome to.
Nah, I'm not fine. I'm cynical enough as it is normally.
I'm happy to fight my battles.
I mean, you're fighting a pretty big battle just playing the game.
It's true.
No, in all seriousness, though, this game. I mean, it's aged okay, you know? It's still pretty enjoyable to play.
Yeah.
So, by all means, go ahead. New runners are always welcome.
Also, something I'd like to point out. Mods of the chat are more than welcome to time out people spamming Nintendo.
Oh, yeah, please do. Actually, don't time them, I'll just permaban them. Oh, nice. There's this really stupid meme going on where people seem to believe that Harry says Nintendo every single time he does any spell ever, but it's not even close.
No.
I don't know where it stems from, but I guess people be having fun.
And it's everywhere.
Yeah. Even, like, new runners. You get them, too.
Oh, is he saying Nintendo?
Oh. No. There are so many, like, stupid memes going on. Somehow I feel like it's our own fault for being a bunch of, I don't know, memes ourselves, but nobody deserves the Nintendo meme, it's so bad.
Speaking of memes, I'd like to give a quick shout out to no one in particular.
Yeah, it's a known legend.
If you're in chat, man, keep being awesome.
You know, we just triggered like so many Nintendos now, you know?
I know.
Yeah.
All part of the master plan.
It must be Bobo Lucas. Yeah, I mean, Nintendo was an inside job.
So normally you're supposed to go and gather all the ingredients to be able to progress, but for an unknown reason they decided to make the walls really low in that area, so you don't have to bother going around to unlock the Flubberworm mucus to be able to walk through and progress on.
Area's a very sloppy student.
So this is one of the Lumos statues that doesn't have a cutscene, and the next one is the final one.
I wonder where Harry learned how to jump like that. So parkour.
My friend in Georgia, of course.
Oh, obviously. Yeah. Because they, like, totally...
They're kind of janky sometimes, because it's difficult to judge the hitbox, or judge the end of the ledge for the beams of light.
Yeah. Depth perception is always fun in video games.
Shoutouts to Max G. Yeah. Alright,
no.
Scream XG.
Yeah. No moving platform boost in HP2. One even. It's a strat in HP2 though.
Yeah.
A lot. All over the place.
All the time.
Yeah.
I didn't have enough space really to be able to move forwards to get enough distance before that jump. So an interesting difference between the European version and the US version. At the start of this lesson, Snape came in and deducted 5 points off me, but in the European version it doesn't actually take it off the tracker for whatever reason. So you, when I first played this game and completed this level, I looked at my house points at the end and thought, wait, I just gained 2 house points. What are you playing at?
Yeah, in some European versions I think he does do that as well. Don't know exactly how.
Go to Europe with all the individual.
Yeah.
There's also a number of smaller differences between the European version and the US version. The US version can skip Peeves. The European version can do the dry storage that we saw in Wingardium. There's going to be a Wingardium section in a later part of a stealth section that uses slightly different platforms to put the blocks on. What's that smell? Just small subtle differences from then.
That's I mean, people have been like kind of like trying to theorize. Oh, hello. Ogre. What an ogre load of fun. No, but like people have been trying to strategize and theorize different localized versions of the European game. So, in particular, languages, and it's interesting because like the Norwegian intro cutscene is like way faster than the English, but then the game just kind of loses. Oh well, you lose time elsewhere over other cutscenes. So it's not really, nobody really knows honestly what's the fastest. It's just a random language thing.
Also, this is your typical Boulder level.
Yeah, this is Boulder Dash.
Interesting thing to note about the color of the beans. The color will change as you get closer to a jump. So they'll always be blue, and then you'll get 2 greens and a pink at the part in which you need to jump off, which is a nice thing that I didn't realize until it was too late.
No, I never knew that.
Obviously nice, the convenient place safe book in case Shrek catches you.
Yep.
Shrek did not fit through that though, but he just went straight in anyway.
Impressive.
Magic.
It's about to get a bit
loud.
Aragog-esque.
If you remember Harry Potter 2 from last year's ESA, with the audio levels being just ridiculously loud for some specific part of the game? Yeah.
This isn't loud as such, it's just a little bit obnoxious.
You'll throw through pen, don't nod. And people will die, so turn down your headphones.
You don't actually need to do that, to be fair, you just need to hit the wall. I just want to mess around for a bit.
Harry really likes Flipendo. Damn.
He really does.
Yeah, it's all over that.
So the idea here is to hit the piece, hit the bits of toilet before they hit either Harry or what we want to avoid is having them hit Ron. Because every time Ron gets hit by the bits of debris, the troll club that he's trying to move on top of the troll will get reset back to a particular point.
That's
so you just extend this section. The optimal place to stand for this section seems to be right next to Ron, but there are occasions when you will just continue missing for whatever reason.
Thanks for saving me.
Which is a bit annoying.
Is he dead?
So we've got the second Quidditch match coming up.
Come on, let's get out
soon. But now we just got a little bit more irrelevant story. Exhausted from their
encounter with the trolls, lots of irrelevant story.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it isn't the real but and discuss the strange. We don't really care much about the story and speedrunning anymore.
No.
It's all about going fast. This is not very fast at all.
The way the game plays, it feels like it's all set in one day. You just go to your Flipendo class, then Alhambra, then Wingardium, etc. And then a little bit later, you have... all of a sudden, you've got to Christmas.
Oh.
Oh.
That guy looked interesting in this room.
I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan.
There's a guy that looked really interesting in this room.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't know if he's doing some sick kickflips or something.
There you go.
This one's slightly trickier, but not really. As long as you get up to it, it's the same. The snitch will follow the same path. Like, it's got a set route that it will take every time, so you just need to get to it and then follow it along that path as the progress bar builds up.
My name's Lee Jordan.
The guy is not having fun today.
His name is Lee Jordan, signing off.
Gryffindor won the Quidditch match against Ravenclaw.
Yeah. Harry Ron, youngest seeker of the century, beating Ravenclaw as well.
Yeah.
It's a pretty impressive win streak right now, 100%. Eventually, after much coaxing, Hagrid agreed. So that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Harry unwrapped the unexpected Christmas present.
Why was it Christmas?
It's an invisibility cloak. It's magic. Look at the Christmas tree, so high res. Literally just like a triangle.
The cone, yeah.
Yeah. And Ron's face is like fantastic, look at it.
Shout out to Ron's face.
Yeah, the infinite
it's
shout
so
out.
So cheeky.
Yeah. It's a great like paper paste onto like a cylinder or something. So his face look like.
It's a fantastic way of showing the use of the invisibility cloak, you know, just decrease its occupacity.
Yeah, I mean. With Norbert safely bundled
why
not?
Harry set off for the tallest tower. It works.
He hoped that so we're about to go into two kind of, not necessarily, well, I mean, this is probably like two of the more challenging platforming sections of the game. It's sneaky and sneaky sneaky. Sneaky up, sneaky down. Pretty much we're going to the astronomy tower right now. And we're gonna, you know, deliver the dragon over to Ron's cousin. And then we have to get back down again. Before we, you know, meet Fluffy and whatnot.
Your guess is as good as mine as to where he's hiding Norbert as of right now.
Yeah, well, let's not go there.
I'd assume he'd hide it in his ears, but that's where my hearing comes out.
Yeah.
You can get kind of close to Filch as well and not have him be a big deal.
Maybe he's in his folio magic.
Maybe.
So your invisibility cloak kind of just like stops functioning when you throw spells, but Filch is pretty blind, so he doesn't really care.
Filch can hear you. Filch can't hear you when you're walking on the carpet, and he can when you're on the hard floor. So you can use that to your advantage when maneuvering yourself around. I'm gonna get this safety save because this is quite a long section here.
And for some reason, in that room that you just was in. I believe there's like a place with a knife above him. Like you can only get there if you super jump. No reason why for why it's there. But
now, how can I get up there?
Shout out to a super jump percent.
Yeah, that's a quote unquote fun category.
No one really takes it that seriously. It's a good little race category that we occasionally do, where you're allowed to use the
kind of a meme.
It's kind of a meme. You're allowed to use the. The game has cheat codes that you're able to use, such as Harry super jump. Harry normal gem. And people occasionally will do races using those codes.
It's a super gem, only percent, but whatever. It's like,
that's disgusting.
Literally, like, you are, the only movement you're allowed to do is super jumping, which... Oh, it gets bad. Gets really, really bad.
Chilaka.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, wow. Oh, well.
It is interesting.
It is interesting. I'm glad I got that save.
Yes,
I was trying to get myself on top of... there's a little part of that thing I was stood on, or trying to stand on, that you can get up onto. I think I'm in the wrong place here.
Now,
might hit
how
me.
Can I get up there?
Yeah.
Good app.
Phil's just a known legend, and he does not take shit from any first-year-olds.
First-year-olds?
Yeah, sure. Let's go with that.
Cool.
Yeah, sure.
I'll try to be a little bit more careful, Stan.
Now, how can I get up there?
How can I get up there?
As the motorettes would sing. Alright, should we try this again?
All good times three.
On de toi.
De toi?
FFZ?
No.
Reminder that if you're on the chat and you don't have FFZ emotes, you're missing out.
Come out. Come
oh, yeah.
Out wherever you are.
I kind of demand that this guy train right now, but I won't be able to watch it anyway. It's a pretty good emote.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
This guy HD coming soon?
Question mark?
Well, apparently Pixel's already sent it me, so...
Oh, yeah.
Gotta do it. Oh. That's a shame. So normally, if you get to that room quick enough, Filch will get stuck in this sort of area here, and then he won't come and block this doorway. Unfortunately, I was a little tardy getting up there.
Yeah, it's more like kind of tight platforming. You're not supposed to do that jump, for instance. You're supposed to use all the bookshelves. You can also do like a straight jump around.
Hello. Yeah, I've been using hyper jumps off that bookshelf to sort of get to places, or yeah, make jumps that I normally wouldn't be able to make.
Yeah, it's all right.
That should be fine. Cool. So there I triggered both cutscenes at the same time, and similarly to the thing that we saw in Incendio, I don't have to watch both cutscenes and they'll both end and in control. Although this one saves about 8 seconds, I think. Because the cutscene that skips is quite long. A little bit more basic platforming. Ledge grabbing. Beans?
Yeah, these ledge grabs can be really weird.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, sometimes they will just, like, throw you off.
Many a times people have fallen off these magnificent platforms.
This wooden thing that I'm on right now, you need to be facing, like, as close to 0 degrees as possible. To be able to grab hold of them, otherwise they will not give you anything. And another safety save.
Right next to the beautiful painting of a wizard. Yeah.
Gorge.
Hogwarts is such a magical place.
It is.
Full of pictures that don't move.
There's candles in chat.
Press F, pay respects. Rip the moving pictures in the 2001 game. Even PS1 had moving platforms. Well, pictures. Alright, that's a bridge skip.
Skips the bridge.
Yeah.
Pretty self-explanatory. And here's another reversing into a cutscene. Make it whiz by. You'll see the pan out just explode off into the distance. So
Ron's brother Charlie. So yeah, what's the first sneaky session? From the tower and return him to Romania. Next one is a bit longer.
Bit longer, a bit scarier.
Maybe not in this case since Res kind of messed up like a million times, but when I say a million, I mean a million and two.
I mean, I'll be doing the same things, just getting the safety saves.
You didn't even incendio her.
Yeah.
Nah.
Damn, forgot
it. If you didn't see it there, it was Mrs. Norris.
Yeah, Mrs. Norris is just kind of chilling there.
Yeah. In this game, she is a plant for some reason.
Yeah, you can throw incendio on it, and it's weird, but keep watch from above. I'm honestly not even surprised, though. Like, it's one of those things where it makes no sense, but at the same time, you're not, you know, surprised at hearing or figuring out that random stuff happens.
It seemed like they wanted somewhere to store a whispered incendio, because that's one of the only spells that you don't get to use in this section. So they just put it in that character, and in case they were going to use it, and they didn't end up doing so. Safety save.
Intruder. Safety strats?
Safety strats?
Lost Viking?
No.
No. No safety strats?
No.
No.
Not with that helmet.
What a based FFC. It's not as good as when you Tom, though.
That's a very exclusive emote as well. Oh, good.
Yeah, not a lot of people will get that.
Not a lot of people can get it either.
No. So many memes spawned from ESA.
So a lot of things happened quite quickly there. The first thing I did was... Oh, nice. There's a long cutscene that you would normally have to do where you go and talk to Nearly Headless Nick and you do some platforming all around the bookshelves into other rooms and go all the way around the section. What I was able to do was use the candle to maintain my height, to give me more height, because it's a slightly sloped object. So I jumped into the candle and at such an angle where I would pass the candle and then be able to grab the bookshelf in front of me. It's kind of precise, but it's not too bad, and it saves about a minute and a half. We used to have to do a super jump, similar to what you saw at FES there, but that was really inconsistent, and even if you got the super jump, it was really difficult to control where you were going. So it was really difficult to do.
The super jump just kind of sends you flying, whatever direction you were facing at the time of, like, the jump. Nothing much you can really, you can't strafe out of it, you can't really change.
Nowadays, the super jump is a backup if you just jump too late or at the right point. You also saw me do like a, I think we called it the YOLO jump, or Keymaker dubbed it the YOLO jump, where you jumped around, jumping straight around a little barrier rather than jumping onto the bookshelves. And then you also saw me cast Alohomora, the second door that I'm walking through now, and what that allowed me to, well, that allowed me to do in the position I opened it at was it would close the door that I just walked through as I was going through, and then as I entered the trigger area it would then open it again rather than having to cast Alohomora later on. Another safety save, because this section could go quite wrong. Hopefully it won't. It's the final part of the stealth section.
Yeah. Some interesting stuff. That's happening.
I can't remember how we got Filch to Hess now. Like, I can't remember what changed to make it so he didn't. But occasionally you just see him sort of moonwalking backwards as he was crouching into the corner where that torch is.
Based Hess.
Based Hess. So these were the platforms I was talking about. In the US, they use the standard ones we store in Wingardium and Lumos. And in this, they just have... They make it look more like the pulley system that's going on to move the blocks of the doors up. I'm going to wait here just to set myself up on such a cycle where I shouldn't get blocked by Filch as I walk past here. And then I kind of want to trap him behind that pillar so that he won't get to me at this door. then the final bit is down to RNG as to how many times Mrs. Norris decided to stop on her prowl round. Okay, cool. She didn't. So normally, well, sometimes I'd have to wait for Mrs. Norris to get all the way past that area before I can continue on.
I think it's worth to point out that the game doesn't actually care if the block is under.
So over there we've got Filch the shorty and Mrs. Norris the tallie.
Yes, I will.
And Peeves.
Peeves.
Hey shorty.
Hey tallie.
Hey shorty.
Just a quick shout out to TVB Takeover.
Everybody post Mr. Machine in chat right now.
Okay, so this is... Actually, no, it's the second to last cutscene that I'm going to be reversing into. That was a really sloppy way of doing it, but I had to hit the pot to make Mrs. Norris run over and get out of the way of the door. And I decided to play it a little bit safe, making sure that I didn't reverse into Norris.
God damn it, Norris.
God damn it, Norris. But I will gain control a little bit earlier than I should. Like that.
Yeah, just ignore the Weasleys.
Yep.
They're just up to no good. We're not interested right now.
So this is pretty much the final segment. This is the part in the film where they go down and get past Fluffy, go and grab the, get through the Devil's Snare, get the key, play chess, fight a boss, and
fight a boss.
Play crazy potions?
Oh, do potions.
Hopefully, good. Potions is good.
Hopefully, we can skip the playing potions.
Oh, I'm assuming we will.
Hopefully.
No doubt about it.
Because playing potions is really, really, really slow.
It is.
Yeah.
It's similar to one of those mini games where you just have one item and everything gets shuffled around and you got to point at what item it was. It can get ridiculously fast, to be fair. The fifth iteration of it. But we can skip it in several ways. Hopefully we'll get the fastest one. If not, we'll probably still get the second fastest one. If not, I'll just attempt the fastest one again.
Yeah, just die.
He's always watching the Forbidden Corridor.
If you mess up the backup or whatever,
you're
pretty much dead.
You attempt the fastest way, then you attempt the backup, and then if you attempt the backup and fail, you get to attempt the fastest way again. And it only takes about 40 seconds for every attempt.
Come on, let's go!
Alright, so one last moonwalk. Getting a little bit of health here. Just a good excuse to prepare myself to turn around and just top my health up. It's good to have a lot of health for the final boss, because you're going to be doing a lot of damage abuse.
Also, it's worth noting
that. This is where the growling has been coming from.
I guess the final boss. We should reveal it yet, because nobody's seen this game yet, obviously, being from 2001. But the guy likes to absolutely spam you down with spells, and it hurts a lot. That's before the actual boss battle starts, too.
Oh yeah, there's two iterations of the boss. One of them is a platforming, dodging section.
Is that it?
And then the other is an actual fight.
Yeah.
So here's the flute that we got given. That one.
30 minutes ago.
That's not that one.
Yeah, so you want to go for the longest one, then the middle one, and the shortest one. Then they'll fall asleep.
Off they go.
There should be time for a donation or
yeah.
So.
We got time for donations. I'm just going to play some flute.
Okay, if we got time for donations. There's a $50 donation from Poker Black. Love this Harry Potter game when I was a kid. It's awesome to see it being played. Good luck to all the runners.
I really hope that didn't break
Come
it.
Come on, Harry.
Yeah, you can soft lock here.
Cool. If you're still playing the flute when Harry's supposed to be moving.
Yeah, it's bad that he doesn't move.
He's done for.
Yeah, he's gone so. Look at this epic, like. It's not even really like models, it's just like a sprite.
of the Sorry, Hermione, what is that again?
Oh.
Help! It's a devil's snare! Oh, just kind of sticky maker.
Just in case you hear it the first time. So very, very true to the lore and canon. We are throwing incendium at it, instead of burning it with light.
I do recall that was the way they accomplished it in the books, right?
Lumos Maximus. No. It's not even it. I don't even remember what they used.
And obviously there was the secret staircase that led back upwards.
Yeah, I mean, why not, right?
Final Quidditch section. You have to catch the key, Harry. I'm not expecting to make the fast cycle, but we will give it a go.
Up.
Good luck, Harry.
Harry. Well, all right. So, good luck to Harry. Not bad.
Don't think I'm fast enough. Nah. You can make it before that turn. That just makes things a lot easier.
Excuse me. Wow, this
that was
key is not
odd.
Giving up.
That's alright.
Shout out to Keymaker.
Shout out to Keymaker.
Well done, Harry. Let's see what this is.
Okay, so coming up now is probably going to be something that will make the super jump look hard, unless I get it first try again. This skip is called Chess CS or Chess Cutscene Skip.
Ooh.
Shout out to SCS.
CHM CS.
So we're going to be getting a super jump using the railings, and we're going to try and get on top of that arch, not the one over there, but the next one we're going to pass. And then we're going to walk along the walls and hopefully get onto the chessboard without talking to Ron and Hermione. Oh, there we go. Cool.
It's a bit dodgy walking in the out of bounds, but once you know where the walls are, stuff, it's fine.
Got him.
Got that one pretty good, mate.
Yeah, now for anyone who doesn't know how chess works, this is exactly how it works.
You might need a guide for this. It does get quite complicated. It's white, then white, then white, then white in a diagonal line. If you need that again, you can probably look it up somewhere. I know it's quite hard to remember.
It's pretty easy to forget.
Sometimes I like to change it up in a bit, and I like to do white, 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 black?
Damn.
Still works. Same result.
Come on, let's go!
Let's go.
Let's go. Right, so.
Looks like you have to choose the right potion. Be careful, Harry. It could be poison.
All right, come on.
Yeah, bobbing Hermione there will.
Be careful, Harry. It could be poison.
Slow down process quite a bit. So, you can walk along the wall there, like the wall walk we saw earlier, and it skips the trigger or whatever for all this to happen. So this fire doesn't happen, this cutscene doesn't happen, and we can just kind of walk through the room.
So this was the crazy questions I was talking about. Can you tell me which one it is? Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. We have another way of dealing with this.
8 out of 10 people will get this wrong.
Cool.
Yeah, shoutouts to me for never getting that.
Yeah. that's the bag. Oh,
I'll grab that just in case.
Does it have to do with the FPS? Or?
No, it's just the way you hit the candle. The angle that you hit the candle when you jump from the slope. It's another one of the jumping into a candle to gain height.
Oh, damn, what a plot twist. Not Quill. Oh no. Whether I'd be meeting you here, Potter. I would have never guessed.
I suppose you were expecting someone else. Where's this scared, stuttering Professor
Quill? I mean, I don't even know anymore. What is real?
So this was probably one of the parts as a casual player where many people got stuck for quite a long time. Quirrell can go in when he wants to.
Yeah,
it's a ridiculous action.
Yeah, he can like throw so many goddamn spells so fast that it's not even funny.
Yeah, this was very cool as a kid.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
They can actually, they can get stuck, these platforms, too.
So what Quirrell will normally do is, if you're behind a block and he can't hit you, he will do the red move where it will push the blocks, and if you're out in open sight, he will attempt to kill you, like so.
Let me hit the green one.
Alright, and I've got good health, so I should be alright for this boss. Again. So this is the final part of the game.
There are like four frogs, so even if you hadn't been off, they got health.
You know what, just in case. I should be absolutely fine, but...
Alright. So we're approaching the final boss of the game. The showdown.
Wow. He has the stone. Interesting thing about this cutscene, just that bit, you can gain control during that line, and so you can just walk to a particular point and it will end the dialogue earlier.
Alright.
So there's a particular pattern to doing this boss. You can see the big pillars around the room.
That looked really painful.
It did. Snapped his own neck. Also, shout out to the fire animation from 2001.
Oh yeah, more sprites. They don't actually exist.
Okay, so you want to get past behind the first pillar, then you want to position yourself so that you're facing the mirror. You can get him to hit himself there. Then you get behind the next pillar and rinse and repeat this. Then once his health is at half, he will destroy all the other big pillars. And you've got to go about it another way. Oh, sugar. Okay. So I'm just going to hide behind this. He's now going to start doing homing attacks. Before he does his big meaty ones that can get him to hit himself. So, time is coming up very soon, by the way. I just need to hit him 3 more times. And this is where I'm going to use my health to damage abuse, to stop him from moving, and then get behind the mirror. 2 more of these and it's all over.
Oh yeah, interesting thing. You can actually cancel his spells with your own. It's interesting.
Yeah, by casting, I stop myself getting knocked back. I've got just enough health. Yeah. And... time.
That's it.
That's it. And that's that. Voldemort explodes into 1,000 pieces, and Harry faints.
And, hey, it's Dumbledore.
Sorry? Oh, 27, not bad.
That's Dumbledore not bad for Marathon, dang. Actually.
What happened? It's only, yeah, it's only about a minute off.
Yeah.
Fair enough. I'm
especially
happy with that.
Considering all the technical issues at first, like, it was still quite decent.
Yeah, not too bad. Alright, well, that was that. Destroyed. But Harry remained fearful. Thank you very much for watching. Next up, we've got Futurama. Quite looking forward to that, actually. So stick around. Should be good. Sharing his concern.
Nevertheless, Harry, if our battles do no more than slow.